This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Andrew Dalby, born 1947 in Liverpool, is an English linguist, translator and historian who has written articles and several books on a wide range of topics including food history, language, and classical texts. Contents 1. Education and early career 2. Regents College and food writing 3. Classics 4. Languages 5. Works 6. Notes 7. External links. Education and early career. Dalby studied Latin, French and Greek at the Bristol Grammar School and University of Cambridge. Here he also studied Romance language. Languages and linguistics, earning a bachelor's degree in 1970. Dalby worked for 15 years at Cambridge University Library, eventually specializing in Southern Asia. He gained familiarity with some other languages because of his work there, where he had to work with foreign serials and afterwards with South Asia and Southeast Asian materials. He also wrote articles on multilingual topics linked with the library and its collections in 1982 and 1983. He collaborated with Cao Seimung in cataloging the Scott collection of manuscripts and documents from Burma, especially the Shan states and Indochina. Dalby later published a short biography of the colonial civil servant and explorer J.G. Scott, who formed the collection to help him with this task. He took classes in Cambridge again in Sanskrit, Hindi and Pali, and in London in Burmese and Thai. Regents College and food writing. After his time at Cambridge, Dalby worked in London helping to start the library at Regents College and on renovating another library at London House Goodenough College. He also served as honorary librarian of the Institute of Linguists, for whose journal The Linguist he writes a regular column. He later did a part-time PhD at Birkbeck College, London in Ancient History in 1987-93, which improved his Latin and Greek. His Dictionary of Languages was published in 1998. Language in Danger, On the Extinction of Languages and the Threatened Monolingual Future, followed in 2002. Meanwhile, he began to work on food history and contributed to Alan Davidson's journal Petites Propos Culinaires. He was eventually one of Davidson's informal helpers on the Oxford Companion to Food. Dalby's first food history book, Siren Feasts, appeared in 1995 and won a Runciman Award. It is also well known in Greece, where it was translated as Cyrenaia Dipna. At the same time, he was working with Sally Granger on the Classical Cookbook, the first historical cookbook to look beyond Apicius to other ancient Greek and Roman sources in which recipes are found dangerous tastes. On the History of Spices, was the Guild of Food Writers Food Book of the Year for 2001. Work on this also led to Dalby's first article for Gastronomica magazine, in which he traced the disastrous exploration of Gonzalo Pizarro in search of La Canela in eastern Ecuador, showing how the myth of the Valley of Cinnamon first arose and identifying the real tree species which was at the root of the legend. Dalby's light-hearted biography of Bacchus includes a retelling, rare in English, of the story of Prosimnus and the price he demanded for guiding Dionysus to Hades. His epilogue to Petronius Satyrica combines a gastronomic commentary on the Feast of Trimalchio with a fictional denouement inspired by the fate of Petronius himself. Classics. Dalby's Rediscovering Homer developed out of two academic papers from the 1990s in which he argued that the Iliad and Odyssey must be seen as belonging to the same world as that of the early Greek lyric poets but to a less aristocratic genre returning to these themes. He spotlit the unknown poet who, long after the time of the traditional Homer, at last saw the Iliad and Odyssey recorded in writing, as he teasingly suggested, based on what we can judge of this poet's interests and on the circumstances in which oral poetry has been recorded elsewhere, it is possible, and even probable, that this poet was a woman. Languages. Dalby's book Language in Danger, The Loss of Linguistic Diversity and the Threat to Our Future, focuses on the decline and extinction of languages from ancient times to the modern era. Dalby attributes the loss to the emergence of large centralized political groupings, the spread of communications technologies, and the hegemony of the English language. Dalby profiles endangered languages and discusses the significance of their disappearance, which he estimates occurs at a rate of 1 every 2 weeks. He states that the world is diminished by each language lost because they encapsulate local knowledge and ways of looking at the human condition that die with the last speaker. He also discusses the way stronger languages squeeze out others, using the rise of Latin and the extinctions that occurred around the Mediterranean in classical times as an example, and notes a similar pattern that Irish, Welsh, and various Native American languages and indigenous Australian languages have faced in the English-speaking world, where they were banned in school to force minority groups to speak the language of the majority. Dalby writes that preferences have shifted toward encouraging minority languages and that many can be saved. His account was described as Engrossing by the Wall Street Journal, the book disputes advocacy of a single common language as a means to a happier, more peaceful, and improved world. Works 1993, Southeast Asia, A Guide to Reference Material 1995, Siren Feasts, A History of Food and Gastronomy in Greece 1996, The Classical Cookbook 1998, Cato, On Farming Translation and Commentary 1998, Dictionary of Languages 1998, Guide to World Language Dictionaries 2000, Empire of Pleasures, Luxury and Indulgence in the Roman World 2000, Dangerous Tastes, The Story of Spices 2002, Language in Danger, The Loss of Linguistic Diversity and the Threat to Our Future, Columbia University 329 pages 2003, Flavors of Byzantium 2003, Food in the Ancient World from A to Z 2005, Bacchus, A Biography 2005, Venus, A Biography 2006, Rediscovering Homer 2009, The World and Wikipedia 2009, Cheese, A Global History Notes Carrot, Sir George Scott, 1851-1935, Explorer of Burma's Eastern Borders in Explorers of Southeast Asia, Ed V. T. King, Kuala Lumpur, Oxford University Press, Penerbit Fahar Bhakta, 1995 Carrot, Christopher Columbus, Gonzalo Pizarro, and the Search for Cinnamon in Gastronomica Volume 1 No. 2 2001 pp 40-49 Carrot, The Satirica concluded, in Gastronomica Volume 5 No. 4 2005 pp 65-72 Carat, The Iliad, The Odyssey and Their Audiences in Classical Quarterly NS Volume 45 No. 2 1995, Homer's Enemies, Lyric and Epic in the 7th Century in Archaic Greece, New Approaches and New Evidence, ed. Nick Fisher and Hans van Wies, London, Duckworth, 1998 Carat, The Idea has been dismissed as far-fetched by Anthony Snodgrass on the grounds that a woman would have been bored out of her mind when composing The Iliad. Carat, McFarlane, Robert A. Crossroads with Two Signposts, Diversity and Uniformity, 25 May 2002, Spectator. Carat, Books on Language, 18 April 2009, Wall Street Journal. Carat, A. B. Michael Derda, A Scholar Explains Why We Don't Want to Teach the World to Speak in Perfect Harmony, 25 May 2003, The Washington Post. External links: Wikimedia Commons has media related to Andrew Dalby. Andrew Dalby at Academia. Do Authority Control WorldCat Identities VIAF, 270385154 LCCN, N950190 0019 ISNI 0000-0001-2135-7998 GND 120894203 SELIBR 232111 SUDIC 0347216 BNF CB 125446 11 D Data NLA 36071529 NDL 0089086 BNE XX14132 59